You've probably heard my voice, but who am I? Coming up next, find out when Studio 10 turns on the lights and reveals the shocking truth.
You never know what will happen next on Studio 10. Make sure you don't miss a minute of the fun right after Wake Up.
Welcome back. Thank you for your company this Thursday morning. Well, years ago, we were afraid to put our full names on the internet. Now, we freely share photos, locations and personal details that potentially put our safety at risk.
Yes, status updates, holiday snaps, GPS location, tagging, and now letting predators know way too much information and potentially making us targets. Our tech and etiquette expert, Danielle DeMassi, joins us here and warns us about oversharing. Hey,
yes,
Dan.
Yes, we love to overshare, but this isn't new, and we want to make sure that that we cover all bases on and offline for those people that aren't oversharers online today.
Just how dangerous can it be for people?
Hugely. It's one of the main things that even on the FBI's website that they talk about. There's so many cases of robberies that happen when people say, we're going out to the band, we're going to the bar, we're going to away for a holiday for 2 weeks, you know, the place is empty. You have so many people on your Facebook connections that you don't always know what they're like now. You might have known them 20 years ago in school. You don't know what their characters are, who they're connected with. And people are being robbed. And there's time and time again, and even Paris Hilton, Lindsay Lohan, they got robbed famously because of their tweets where they were. So then the robbers knew that they weren't home. So that's where they got robbed.
I think a major issue for a number of people today is the fact that the whole GPS.
Yes.
You know, the fact that if you post an Instagram picture or even and tweet something, it can actually locate where you are.
Yeah, and there's signs actually going up in gaming parks in Africa, so forth, asking people, please don't share your photos on social media until you're out of the park, because actually poachers are even using the GPS locations of the photos to know where the rhinos are.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. So this is, it's much bigger than just us wanting to share in the moment. So just start to think about what else is happening.
So would that be your tip, just a bit of awareness? What else can you actually do to stop this from occurring?
Think about who you are sharing the information with. Does everyone need to know? I was talking to someone yesterday, they're like, yeah, someone was saying that they've broken up with their boyfriend. Now we know that they're home alone. Then said, got a spare room in the house. This is the address. Took photos of it. So now we know your exact location. We know that you're there alone, and then starts talking about all the places you're going to. So you're really just giving them a blueprint of how to follow you.
On top of that, we're hearing that would-be thieves and burglars can actually go on and they can look at domain.com and realestate.com, and they can actually case the joint by looking at the photos and looking at the videos of properties that have been sold previously.
Absolutely. And they're also going to showings and sussing out where everything is and where you'd keep things and so forth, and then waiting for it to be tenanted again, which they can see online. But this isn't a social media. I'm pro tech. So it's just, again, it all comes back to your awareness to go, let's just think about this a little bit.
And also knowing it, as I mentioned before, some people don't know that when you do post that picture, it actually shows your location.
Absolutely. And you can turn all that off. Like, they're really good with settings. And that's why there's such books as Raising Digital Families for Dummies.
Excellent.
I didn't write this, but Wiley do lots of things. But I think it's hilarious reading through it, because when we read it and find out about it, we go, of course. But it's common sense.
Now, there's the My Family stickers yes. that we see on some people's cars. You've got them.
Oh, do you? You do not.
He does. He loves them.
Don't you dare say that to me.
Why is this position available?
Okay.
Does that mean that I need a new family member?
Hello? No, it's like the dad's gone. Or I've seen ones with a big cross out of the dad. I did see one of this girl. This was in the eastern suburbs in Sydney. And it was a girl picture. And she had a cat times 19. I'm like, way to tell everyone you're a crazy cat lady. Probably
not. There it is. There. You've got an actual picture over there. So how are these putting people in danger, though?
Well, usually it's not this extreme. That is a cat. I'm not too sure what guy's going to follow you home after that. But what we generally see, where we generally see... We generally see a girl and a cat, and then people are like, hey, follow me home, everyone. Like, I've got no one to protect me, and I'll even drive you to my door.
Yeah, okay, so the key talking point out of this is
just think
be
about
aware,
it.
Think about it, be alarmed.
Just think about it. Yeah. Don't be crazy cat lady.
And she's the contact message. Sam Mac.
Yeah.
Take
if,
off my
family. If you are a crazy cat lady, then we have the man for you.
Thank you very much. Thanks, very important message, though.
Definitely.
Well, you are watching the second last episode of Wake Up right here on 10. We'll be back in just a moment. Mm. Welcome back. Thank you for your company this Thursday morning. Now, do you know the feeling when every scene in a movie is predictable and then our friends can't help themselves but talk about the ending we haven't seen? Guilty as charged. They're called spoilers.
Yeah, thanks. Never going to a movie with you ever again. Well, a company in the UK has signalled the birth of interactive cinema, where basically the outcome of the movie changes depending on how you feel.
Ah, the cinema, the bright lights, the overpriced snacks, the anti-piracy ads everyone videos, all the romance of the silver screen. The problem is those endings. It's always so, well, so predictable. Even your favourite films always end the same way, which is probably why they're your favourite. But what if a film could change its storyline depending on what you feel? Well, now it can, thanks to Trey Azam, who some of you might remember from that Apprentice programme.
So what does that actually mean? If I'm watching a film, what can I do to the film? You say it's interactive. You can't change a film, can you?
Well, you can if it's got multiple narratives. So interactive traditional movies have been interactive in the past, but the problem is you've had to stop and choose.
There's only one kind of possible tiny problem that I can think of with this. So you've had a rough day at work. You come home, you think, I'm gonna stick a film on, I just wanna relax and watch my favourite film, and you're not really paying attention to it, and that changes the ending and the hero dies.
Pay attention is what I would say you would learn from that, but it comes down to the type of movie. So if you wanted to watch a movie that was relaxing, for instance, you could watch a specific type of movie that's designed to respond to your relaxation. If it finds that you're getting bored, it will slow down the action, it will slow down the storyline. The whole point is it responds to you. If you choose you're tired and I don't want to play, it will go down a different route, or you could play a movie. I mean, if you're going to play a gangster movie when you're tired and don't want to interact, you might expect to get shot.
That is controlled by your mind.
It's controlled primarily by your mind.
Time to have a play and see what this interactive brain-controlled cinema thing's all about. Trey's got us hooked up to a game based on Keanu Reeves' samurai epic 47 Ronin. Why? Because samurai have to concentrate. In this case, if we don't concentrate, Keanu Reeves dies, and nobody wants that. Unfortunately, it does mean that if you have to leave to go to the toilet, everyone will be dead when you get back. Maybe.
Yeah, I actually had a go at one of those, the interactive movie.
Did you?
Yeah, you strap it to your head, it reads your brain waves, and then it responds.
Didn't take long.
What do you mean, didn't take long?
Don't worry.
No, and then what you see on the screen interacts with exactly what's going through your head. And my screen just went to black.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Yeah, didn't take long. You're very kind. You're a sweet, sweet, yeah, caring woman. Now, look, very sadly, it is our second last show today. We've been having a lot of fun, and hopefully we've been bringing you a lot of fun as well. Nuala has been helping us out, of course, with animals and her love of them. Now, one thing I'm not sure I'm going to miss so much is you, Nuala, singing. Let's, if we can, one final time, remind our viewers exactly what I'm talking about.
With you.
Yeah, the duet by herself in a glass box in Melbourne. Nuala, it was so much fun. It actually made my week when you did that, but it's a song that sort of swept the entire world. But it would appear that I'm not the only one who was a little tired of hearing it, but you've got another favourite song as well. Check this out. Good girl, always have to be concealed. Oh. Don't let them know.
There you go, Knowles.
Thank goodness you do not have control of the lights here in Federation Square. Or you would be turning them off every time that I don't actually sing, I just mouth the words.
I mime
to Frozen. Don't judge me. Well, you know what, Tash? If we're going to bring up singing...
No.
You know what goes really well with singing is dancing. Yeah. Have you ever done that in the studio when you didn't realise that someone was filming you?
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. Do we have that tape? Touché.
I used to think that I kind of had cool moves. I don't, do I?
Guys? Anyone?
Entertaining. No.
That was a cool move.
Yeah, in the 1970s it was, not now.
So at what point in this journey did you go from thinking, yeah, I've got cool moves, to, oh my God, I'm Elaine Bennis from Seinfeld? Wait, was it a slow transition? Or was there a sort of a light bulb moment that eventually occurred?
Oh, thanks again, James, for your support. Nuala?
That's what I'm here for. Hey, Nuala.
We love you very much.
Thanks for being so awesome today. We will see you tomorrow, and then tomorrow night, karaoke. You know what's happening.
Oh, yeah, it is on. Guess what we'll be singing?
The Frozen song.
Frozen song.
Gonna come.
Oh, there it is.
No. Okay. We'll see you tomorrow, Nuala. Big thanks to Nuala.
Yeah, absolutely. And as we mentioned earlier, it's our second last show today and our last show tomorrow. And we want to take this opportunity to say thank you so much for the overwhelming support we have received. We've adored bringing you all the fun and entertainment and, you know, it's tackling some pretty serious issues on this show as well.
Yeah, I think that was always our manifesto, to try and make sure that you knew what the big stories were, understood the big stories, but at the same time had a laugh so you could get into your day with a smile on your face. We certainly have at every single moment we've come into. A lot of them have, of course, been at your expense, but you know.
And also, tomorrow, brace yourself. I've got a bit of a kind of mixed tape of your dancing.
Oh, have you?
Yes.
You'll be up late in the edit suite. I can imagine. Yeah, tomorrow we are going to have a look back at all the fun we've had on the show. And of course, we'll bring all the latest news as well. But your outpouring support on our Facebook page has been absolutely fantastic. And it's you, the viewers, who've made this journey such a wonderful experience for Natarsha and I. Stick around though now. We're going to be back tomorrow.
Thanks.
The guys from Studio 10 are going to take you through the rest of the morning.
Bye.
See you then.